Howdy, my name is Brett Kingman. Thank you for joining me in my little studio here in Mount Eliza, Victoria, Australia. This is the Ampero 2 stage, which has just enjoyed a firmware update to version 1.04. There's a few new boogie amps in there. There's a new reverb, other tweaks and surprises and all sorts of fun, really. It's a great little unit. If you know you want something that's high quality and grab and go, that's not going to really bust your budget balls, so to speak, then this is probably a good one to look at. And today I want to look at building a preset. The preset that you've just been listening to is one of mine, based around a good old Princeton amp, and I've got five scenes there with a couple of extra effects knobs up the top. So scene one is clean, scene two is dirty, probably too much reverb, which I'm just going to turn down a little bit right now, mix down, that's better, a bit better. Three is the lead tone, four has got a bit of sort of fusion-y chorus stuff going on. And then five gets, you know, into sort of ambient worship world. And within each of those scenes, I can bring in a phaser. Or a tremolo. Or both. So I thought it might be fun to watch how my mind works, and we'll build a preset from scratch. So I'm going to go to my Ampero 2 edit software here, which is basically an exact reflection of what's going on the screen on the hardware, but it's a lot clearer for your eyes, and the camera doesn't shoot this that well, so we're going to watch the screen. I'm going to pick a new preset, an empty preset, and do I want to save the patch? Yeah, I'm going to save the patch. I'm going to go to empty. Now, up here, you will find a selection of different factory signal path templates. One's parallel, one's a split mix, one's an AB to Y, which looks like that. And right down the bottom is the one that I prefer, which is a classic serial signal path. That means that the input is coming in here, and it's going along these 12 different blocks, which you can fill with whatever you want, and then the output's coming out here. So I want to make this a kind of kitchen sink preset. That means I'm going to need a fairly clean sort of amp to begin with. So I'm going to select this block because I know I'm going to put other crap before it. Not crap, other stuff before it. So this block can be my amp block. I'm going to go over to here, and I'm going to make a selection from the dozens of amps. I'm not sure exactly how many there are. Let's have a look at my favorite clean amp is always the black Princeton. So it looks like that. It's just got four basic controls, volume, output, bass, and treble. And then we're going to need to team that with, so there it is. It needs to be teamed with a cabinet. And if I select cabinet here, it's going to select automatically the cabinet that HOTONE recommend, which in this case is a Fender Deluxe Reverb 1x12 combo. You get a selection of microphones to listen to that combo IR with. I know that Mix 2 has a 57 and a Royal 121 in it, so I'm going to use that because it's nice and soft, and it's got a good mid-range, and I'm going to place it or those near the near center. Maybe the cap edge. I'm going to apply a little low-cut filtering up to about, I don't know, 100. That's going to take the boominess away. If I'm recording, it's not going to get in the way of the bass drum and the bass guitar, which is a good thing. I'm going to go back to this amp block, and I'm going to turn down the bass even a little bit more. Just give myself a little bit more treble and a little bit more volume. Now that patch volume is pretty loud, so up here is your preset volume. I'm going to back it down to about 60, maybe even less, 50. And I'm going to drop the output. The clean amps tend to be louder than the dirty amps. Maybe that's a saturation thing, I don't know. But it's something to remember when you're creating presets in your Ampero 2 stage. All right, I've got a nice clean, fairly simple amp. Let's stick a reverb at the end to give it a bit of room, and Which reverb am I going to choose? I'm going to choose the concert hall reverb. Yep, that's good. I'm going to stick the trails on so when I switch it out, it's still going to ring through, and I'm going to drop the mix a little bit. Decay is fine. Nothing wrong with that at all. Up the front here, I'm going to apply a little noise gate, and I'll find that noise gate in the dynamics section, which that's DYN over there, and I'm going to use the AI gate, and I'm going to bump the threshold up to about here, which won't make much difference when I'm running clean, but once I bring some drives in, which I will be doing, it will make the difference between noisy and not so noisy. Next to it, I'm going to pop a compressor for my clean tones especially, and the compressors, which compressor today? There's four compressors up here. Compresso Comparoma 4, which I think is Robert Keeley's, a model of Robert Keeley's, the Blue Sustainer, and the Squeezer, which I like the Squeezer. Yeah, that's good. A bit more squeeziness, bump the threshold up. Great, so my clean tone is... pretty darn good already. I might like a chorus in there as well, so let's go to modulation. There's a few choruses here to choose from. The Azura Chorus. The Grand Chorium. And the Liquid C. Liquid C I like. That's a kind of a Dimension D sort of a thing, if I'm not mistaken. And I like Mode 2. So Mode 2 it is. But I'll turn that off for the moment. And I think we'll have a... let's have a delay as well, shall we? Because don't mind the rooms. Which delay will it be? Look at all of these delays. There's a ton of delays. So I'm going to choose something that I know I can work with pretty quickly. That'll be the tape delay S for stereo. I'm going to put it on sync so I can tap tempo it if I want, and I'm going to turn trails on again so it will trail out if I switch it off. Up here is a time ratio for the right speaker. So I'm going to make it 75%. Where's my keyboard? There it is. Bump that up a little bit more. Beautiful. And I'm going to use, there's an age thing here, which is like kind of like the age of the tape. So at the moment it's on pass. If I bring it into present, it's going to be a bit more presence. Great. All right. And now let's turn him off and let's put some drives in. And actually, I'll put delay over here because I might pop in a little bit of tremolo. We'll see how much CPU room we've got. That's kind of important as well. All right. I want a drive. I want the classic old 808 drive. There are a lot of drives, like tons and tons of drives, right up to the sort of metally plexi things. I'm bit of an old school guy, so I'm just going to use the classic old 808 run like this. Probably wouldn't use it with the compressor in front. That's better. Okay, so basically I've given myself there an 808 flavoured booster because the gain is wound down. Over here, I'm going to put something with a little more oomph in. Which one's it going to be? What's going to be good with the Princeton? I think the good old Super Overdrive, which is a classic old Boss unit with a bit of gain. Not so much tone. Yeah, boy. All right, now we're talking. Preset's getting loud. Back him off a bit now. If I bring this guy in front of it and stack the drives, it's going to be pretty good lead tone, I think. And it's not bad, but it's a bit overkill. So in the scene section, which we'll get to in a moment, I'll fix that right up. I've got my chorus. Let's put a tremolo in there. I've got room for a tremolo. Yeah, custom tremolo. Here we go. Okay, that's good. And over here, I've got room for one more modulation pedal, which I think could be a phaser, perhaps. Is it going to let me put a phaser in there? It is. So it's going to be the 90 phaser, which is a classic old MXR script 90 phaser. All right, so now I have everything there I need for a full rig. This is where it becomes fun. In scene one, you've got scenes, right? Scenes are basically the on and off state of each of the effects, but not just the on and off state, the parameters as well, which is a very welcome thing because not all of the modelers will give you the parameter control with scenes. Most of them only give you the on and off state, or at least the one that I'm thinking of does. So this is, you know, this is a cool feature. I want scene two to be kind of a rhythm dirty sound. So scene one is my clean sound, which is great. Scene two, I want to be a bit of a rhythm dirty sound, so I'm going to bring in, I'm going to turn the compressor off, I'm going to bring the drive on, turn that one on, and I'm going to back it down a little bit. That's good. I'm going to drop that reverb mix. Fantastic. I think I better save this now because I'm getting making some good headway. What am I going to call it? Where am I going to save it? 26, 26, 26, 26, 25. Save it to 27.1 and I'm going to call it rig just because that's original. R-I-G, rig. Great. So, scene one, clean. Scene two, dirty. Scene three, let's make scene three a bit of a lead kind of thing. So I want both drives. I want the delay. Excellent. I'm going to turn this guy down a little bit and drop his gain because the tube screamer is in front pushing it, right? Great, nothing wrong with that. Save, save, patch. So I'm saving as I'm going. It's always a good thing to do, I think. Scene four, I would like to be kind of a lushy, chorusy sort of a thing. So we'll bring in that chorus. We'll keep the compressor on. Oops, that's the tremolo. Here's the chorus over here. Yep, fantastic. Save patch, and then scene five can be the full-on ambient affair, which means I'm going to want more delay, especially turn it on there, and more reverb with a big long decay. And some wow and flutter from that delay, so I get a bit of modulation. Yep, I like it. All right, so scene one is clean. Scene two is dirty crunch. Scene three is hero world. Scene four is, in fact, let's just give him a bit of crunch too. That's good. Save that. Save. Always saving as you go. Scene five was the ambient. So I've got one preset based around a Princeton model with all of these drives and modulations and things that I can switch with these foot switches, but I haven't assigned the foot switches, so let us do that now. I go over to the foot switch icon up here. I'm presented with this panel, which basically gives me 1 to 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then I can assign whatever I want to each of those 7 foot switches, so really dead easy. So for number 1, I want scene 1. For number 2, I want scene 2. For number 3, I want scene 3. Number 4, scene 4, so on and so forth, scene 5. 6 and 7, I could either leave as is, which will give me a tuner, access to the tuner and or the banks for other presets, but I actually want to employ them to turn little things on and off, like the phaser and like the tremolo. So here we go. That's done. Phaser. Oops, must have got the wrong one. Let's go back there and fix that up. That's better. Okay, so scene 1, scene 2, scene 3, scene 4, scene 5. All a bit loud, so I'm going to back this off even more. I'm going to turn the amp's output down a bit. Great. And then I've got this tuner press pedal over here, which is basically seeing my guitar signal. And if I back the heel down, it lets me tune up, which is a really cool thing. This is a HOTONE product as well. I'm a bit sharp. I'm not going to worry about it now, but it becomes a volume pedal then. And if I click it, it becomes an expression pedal, and it means I can assign that expression pedal to any of the parameters here as well. That's pretty good. So that's my little rig, and that's my presentation for today. I better save it now. Save patch. And I'll actually export that. You can go over to the spot that you've saved it in and you can right click and you can say export patch, and it'll bring up a contextual window, and then you say choose and dump it somewhere on your hard drive. And if there's a place to upload it so you guys can try it, I'll do that. But otherwise, thank you for watching. This is a great unit, Ampero 2 Stage. If you want something that's really simple, great interface. The scenes feature is fantastic because it lets you save different parameters and the on and off states in each of those blocks. Good stuff. Thanks for watching. See you soon.